Impeachment, Huckleberry Finn, and Big Fish are all on this day. Hey, welcome back to On This Day. Today is December 10th, 2020. It is the 345th day of the year. We got 21 days left in this sad, sad year. It's the 50th Thursday and the 80th day of fall. We got 11 days till winter. Today is Human Rights Day. Human Rights Day commemorates the day on which the United Nations issued the Universal Declaration of Human Rights in 1948. This document serves as an outline of the fundamental human rights that are to be universally protected. Human Rights Day is observed annually on December 10th. All right, let's see what else December 10th has given us. 1861, during the Civil War, the Confederate States of America accept a rival state's government pronouncement that declares Kentucky to be the 13th state of the Confederacy. 1884, Mark Twain's Adventures of Huckleberry Finn is published. The book was first published on this day in the United Kingdom and in 1884, a couple months later, in the United States, actually February of 1885. Commonly considered one of America's greatest novels. The book follows Huckleberry Finn and his friend Tom Sawyer. They're in another book, Tom Sawyer. But this book follows the boys as they travel along the Mississippi River. The novel is known for its colorful description of people and places along the Mississippi. The journey also includes an escaped slave named Jim. This book has come under fire over the years for a lot of different reasons. But mainly, Huckleberry Finn deals with the treatment of other races, but mostly about slaves. Some people say the book promotes stereotypes and encouraged racism. One man actually went as far as saying this is a training or recruiting book for future white supremacists. I think that one's a little over the top. The book for its time, this was normal. These days, it's horrible. Others say humanizing Jim and exposing the fallacies of the racist assumptions of slavery, it is actually an attack on racism. So it's just how you view it. But to be honest, the N-word gets dropped quite frequently in this book. So much that in 1955, CBS tried to avoid controversial material in a televised version of the book. They deleted all mentions of slavery and omitting the character of Jim entirely. He was an integral part of the story. But yeah, they did that. Other times they've released the book without the N-word and got rid of some of the less politically correct terms in the book. But yeah, things change and I don't know if you should get rid of the past. I think they are there to serve as a cautionary tale in a lot of ways. Things like that are sort of there to remind us how not to be, I think. 1898, the Spanish-American War. The Treaty of Paris is signed, officially ending the conflict. 1901, the first Nobel Prize ceremony is held in Stockholm, Sweden, on the fifth anniversary of Alfred Nobel's death. 1906, U.S. President Theodore Roosevelt wins the Nobel Peace Prize for his role in the mediation of the Russo-Japanese War, becoming the first American to win the Nobel Prize. 1963, Zanzibar gains independence from the United Kingdom as a constitutional monarchy under a dude that calls himself Sultan. I can't even pronounce it, but it's like Jasmid bin Abdullah. Yeah, I think that's right. I hope so. Don't bother correcting me if I got it wrong. 1989, Mongolia Revolution. They had a revolution, didn't even know. The country has its first open pro-democracy public demonstration. 1993, the last shift leaves the Wearmouth Colliery in Sunderland, England. The closure of the 156-year-old pit marks the end for a coal mine that had been open since the Middle Ages. I saw an interesting thing there that way back in the day, like early 1900s and stuff. If you were a boy and you were born in that town, you didn't go to college. You were expected to go work at the colliery or your parents would be fired from working from the company. Yeah, that kind of sucks. 2019, Democrats in the U.S. House of Representatives announce formal charges against Donald Trump that accuse him of abusing power and obstructing Congress, making him only the fourth U.S. president in history to face impeachment. Movies released on December 10th, 1999. We got two great ones. The Green Mile, Tom Hanks, Michael Clark Duncan, who passed away sadly, and The Cider House Rules. Loved both those movies, but they're nothing compared to what was released in 2003. My absolute favorite movie of all time, Big Fish. Such a good movie. The movie is about the relationship between a father and son, really, but there's so much more to this. While on his deathbed, a former traveling salesman with a knack for storytelling tells the story of his life to his son. His son's actually like a journalist, so it's kind of interesting. But the son becomes frustrated because he can't decipher what is fact and what is fiction. His dad told all these really wild stories all the time, and it was entertaining to people. He wasn't just this compulsive liar, he just told these really outlandish stories. And the son goes out and meets some of the people that are in these stories, and that's the interesting part of it. Definitely watch that movie. If you've never seen Big Fish, you have to see it. It's so good. It's got Danny DeVito, Helen Bonham Carter, Ewan McGregor, Jessica Lange, Steve Buscemi, Albert Finney, who just died last year, Billy Crudup, and Robert Guillaume. Great movie, though. If you ever get a chance, definitely watch that. Born on December 10th, 1830, Emily Dickinson, American poet. Hadn't thought about her in years. 1957, Michael Clark Duncan. We just talked about him. He starred in The Green Mile. Sadly, he died in 2012. He was only in his 50s. So sad. Big man, though. They never seemed to last long. 1969, Rob Blake, Canadian ice hockey player and manager. He played for the Los Angeles Kings hockey team forever. Now, I have to say Los Angeles Kings hockey team. One time I said the Staples Center is where the Kings play. Some idiot went off on some tangent about, I'm such a fool, I don't even know where the Kings play. They play in Sacramento or something. Okay, there's a Kings in basketball that's actually where they do play. And then there's the Los Angeles Kings in Los Angeles. I informed him of that and he blocked me. People are ridiculous. Speaking of not lasting long, died on December 10th, 1896. Alfred Nobel, Swedish chemist and engineer. He invented dynamite and founded the Nobel Prize. He gives out a peace prize after inventing dynamite, which has been blowing things up since forever. 2005, we lost Richard Pryor, American comedian, actor, producer, and screenwriter. Everybody knows Richard Pryor, especially if you were born in the 60s or 70s. To see that man do stand-up comedy, it was groundbreaking at the time. Now all kinds of idiots do the same type of thing. At the time, he was amazing. All right, that's today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you got some information out of it. Now go out, do something positive for yourself. Have a great day. Be nice to each other.